Good morning to everyone and welcome back to day two of the synchronous interactive sessions of the faculty development program on use of ICT for online and blended learning. So yesterday what we did was looked at a lot more details of how you can create and implement a flipped classroom in your own for your own course. What we will do today is actually go do things in a little more broader fashion. So we will start and we will go stick with the topic of the purpose of why you're doing different activities. So we'll start with learning objectives, learning purposes, learning goals, and so on. And then because we are focusing on online and blended learning specifically in this FDP, we have to talk about the role of technology and how it aligns to the learning purpose. As we mentioned yesterday and as we keep repeating, for us, technology is a facilitator or an enabler. We don't say, here is the technology I have, oh, it's so cool and I need to use it. Rather, we start with the learning goals, learning objectives, the purposes for which we are doing our activities, the purpose for which our students are there in our classrooms. So we start with the learning goals, and if you notice, I'm not even saying teaching goals. Those are also important, but ultimately, what we want is that our students are engaged and they learn and so on. So the role of technology here is to aid us in many ways to fulfill the learning goals. So what we will see today is that for a particular learning goal, multiple technologies are possible. Starting from no digital technology at all. That is, you can start with, by the way, something like a chalk and blackboard is also considered as technology. Books or printed material were considered as radical technologies in the 1600s. So technologies are tools. We won't spend too much time on those because that's something we're all very familiar with. But we will mention it wherever appropriate that for a particular learning purpose or a learning goal, how do we use a variety of technologies? Focusing more on the digital technologies. Conversely, given a certain technology, we will see how it can be used for a variety of learning purposes. So it's not at all it's not a suitable question if we ask something like, is PowerPoint or are slides good? Is PPT effective? That's not a meaningful question. The more meaningful thing to ask is, what are we using it for? How are the students interacting with it? What is the teacher doing with it? And so on. So for a few technologies, what we will do is explore its potential, its affordance for a variety of learning goals, starting from a recall level to a much higher level, something like evaluate or create or design and so on. So that's sort of the plan for the morning. And we will have interaction sessions today. In the afternoon, what you will do is actually go to the lab and create something for your own flipped classroom. It may be a continuation of yesterday or it may be something new, but you will create something for your own course in the lab today. So what I'll do now is hand the mic over to Jai Krishnan. He will lead us through the activities for the next 1 hour or so. And as usual, at 11 o'clock, close to 11, we will break for tea.
Warm good morning to all the participants. So as Professor Sanamuthi told you, the focus of this session will be on the learning purpose and aligning the technology used to the learning purpose. So let me just start with the main session, the first session today. It is aligning technology tools with learning purpose and why we do it to increase the effectiveness of the blended or online education. A quick polling activity. You can send the answers through AVU chat. Yesterday evening, many of you, so we had given the final session as a lab. So RC centers, RC coordinators, can you kindly take a quick poll among your RC center and tell us how many participants in your RC located a video for their own course yesterday. So this was the lab assignment that we gave yesterday. So a quick number of how many participants in your RC located a video. Okay, as I see here, we have a healthy mix of A and B, and there are few C's. So, one advice to the people who have not yet found or located videos. So, there is another lab session today, and you have the entire time this week to locate videos. All the necessary links have been provided in the flipped classroom activity constructor. All you have to do is go through these links or even do a Google search if nothing works out fine. And of course, this is a collaborative community. So, in case people are having still trouble, just post it in the discussion forum and see whether you get a response from peers from your same domain. Okay, this is, so we had asked all of you to watch 3 videos before coming to class today. This was under the session for face-to-face session, videos for revised Bloom's taxonomy. This was there in the IIT Bombay X platform. Now, RC centers, can you just query your remote center and see how many have actually watched these videos? Okay, there is a healthy mix of A and B with a few C's. So, advice to the people who have not yet watched the videos, the content that is going to happen, that we are going to cover across this session is connected to the revised Bloom's taxonomy, which has 6 levels. Slowly we will go through it. So, make use of, take the help of the people who have actually watched these videos during the activities that will be posted during the session, so that you will come to know what was covered in those 3 videos. So, you will have only a brief idea, but we will try to make sure that you go back and watch the videos so as to clearly understand what these 3 videos contained and how the connection was made. So, recall the flipped classroom figure that was shown yesterday. We said that information transmission is transferred to outside the class and assimilation is transferred to inside the class. So, our goal as a teacher is to increase the effectiveness of a flipped classroom or any sort of blended education or blended or online education that we are practicing. What research says is effectiveness increases when the process is learner-centered. You saw active learning strategies, which has a very good empirical evidence and research base. We recommended active learning strategies in class because they are always learner-centered and it will engage them a lot more. So, in class, these are done using active learning strategies. So, traditional classrooms, if you introduce active learning, you will be able to increase effectiveness. Now, in an online or blended education learning format, such as a flipped classroom, technology can assist, but it has to be used with careful thought, which means that you will have to carefully design the activity, making the optimum use of the technology affordance. So, what I am trying to bring in here is the learner focus. We earlier said information transmission. So, it is like I or as an instructor, we are delivering the instruction to the students. But rather in an online and blended education format, it is actually information acquisition where the learners go to different places and acquire the necessary information outside the class, and it is the assimilation that is going to happen in the class. So, we as instructors will facilitate in this information acquisition process, and the role of technologies like video, etc., is to help in this information acquisition process. So, you would be recalling this video. This is the first video that you had to watch. So, a normal video, what we say is transmit instructor's lectures. That is the regular concept. In an online and blended scenario, it is the learners acquire information through these video lectures. Now, these are some of the learning purposes that a video can be used. So, you will have to identify which of the learning purposes does a normal video serve? A normal video means it is just all the contents are being, whatever is the concept, it is being described with examples and other maybe with slides. So, which of these following learning purposes does a video serve? Option A, show various levels in revised Bloom's taxonomy. Option B, probe participants to apply their knowledge in Bloom's taxonomy. Show examples at each levels of Bloom's taxonomy. And D, explain the cognitive processes at each level of revised Bloom's taxonomy. So, now would be a good point for the people who have not watched, check with their peers and get a feedback of what it was all about. You can send your answers through AVU chat. So, I am seeing all the options coming in the chat, but primarily A, C, D. I don't see any B. Okay, some people have said C and D. Okay, so you can stop sending the chat. We got a understanding that many of you are saying it is A, C or D. In fact, the answer is all three are correct. The videos that we provided you, it showed the various levels in revised Bloom's taxonomy, which is at a recall level. It showed examples at each level of revised Bloom's taxonomy, how learning objectives were written at each level of revised Bloom's taxonomy. And it also explained the cognitive processes at each level of that were involved in the levels of Bloom's taxonomy. So, the final one is at an understand level, whereas the A and C options are primarily at a recall level. So, B is not a valid answer because the normal videos, there are no features which will probe participants to apply their knowledge in Bloom's taxonomy. So, there weren't any questions in the video, in a normal video that will help you in doing this probing. So, probing is generally when you ask open-ended questions or some kind of questions to elicit your understanding. So, this I am not doing this activity because I have just now said it. The showing various levels and showing examples are at recall level, whereas explaining the cognitive process is at an understand level. So, this entire process, which is at recall and understand level, is primarily the information acquisition that a learner is going to receive through video. So, one learning that you can get from this is that a same technology can be used for learning purposes at multiple levels of revised Bloom's taxonomy. So, see over here, the same video itself, you are using it for recall and understand. So, a technology can facilitate multiple levels of cognitive processes within a learner as identified by the revised Bloom's taxonomy. Now, this is a brain race activity. So, what does it mean? Brain race means you will have to quickly think of the answer to the question and just type it. So, remote center coordinators, this is the question. What other technologies can be used for the same information transmission purpose? So, the information transmission or information acquisition purpose. Show various levels, show examples, explain. So, showing something and explaining something. What are the other technology tools that you can use? Okay, you can post your answers in the AVU chat. Okay, we are getting answers, screencasting, animation, chalk and talk, slides, Skype, PPT, simulation, examples. A lot of you are saying PowerPoint, which is, I think, a most common form of information transmission slash acquisition. Magazines, yes. So, all the print technologies are also a valid option. Audio, yes, very good. Somebody has correctly identified, yes, audio information can be given either as podcasts or some recordings. Internet, yes, basic website search. So, websites are typical examples. Books. So, we would ask you to scope it down. From internet. Internet is a broad technology per se. So, narrow it down to one aspect of internet. It may be website, it may be wiki. So, come to things like that. Google, which is which I think you need to specify more. Quiz, somebody is saying quiz. So information transmission through quiz, try to rethink it. Quiz is not generally information transmission per se. Net meeting, okay. Moodle, people who are saying LMSs like Moodle, you'll have to specify specific activity within the Moodle. It may be folder uploads and other things. EduBlocks, okay, somebody has mentioned. So EduBlocks, it could be, yes, in a way it is, it can be used for information transmission. Cassettes, repositories, yes, repositories are a valid answer. So many of you are saying the right thing. So possible candidates, it could be Word, it could be PowerPoint, it could be static websites, blogs, wikis. So it could be any of these technologies. So what do you understand from this? There are multiple candidate technologies at various levels of complexities for the same purpose. So a website is completely different from an animation. So a static website is maybe a less complex technology, and whereas an animation is a complex technology, but both have been used for the same, can be used for the same purpose, that is information transmission slash acquisition. So it is important to note that one technology can be used at multiple levels and multiple technologies can be used for the same purpose. Now let me just, so for people who have actually watched this particular segment of the video, so within our videos there is something called reflection spot, where you are asked to pause the video, think about some a question that is posed, and then write the answer in your notebook. So here the instruction is, choose a topic that you teach. In that topic, think of the learning objective for recall level and one for understand level. Write the learning objectives in your notebook. So it has actually asked you to apply the knowledge or the information that you received till now into a new situation. That is, the new situation is your own course and your own topic. So a quick question: which of the learning purposes does the reflection spot in the video serve? So I told you, these are the instructions in reflection spot. Pause the video, think about a posed question, and then write the answer. So the question is, which of these learning purposes does the reflection spot serve in those videos? So remote center coordinators, please post your answers. Okay, I saw a lot of B's and some C's. Some people are saying B and C. Okay, you can stop sending the responses right now. I'm just going to show you the answer. In fact, it is only B. This is the place where we have probed participants to apply the knowledge in revised Bloom's taxonomy in a new context. Showing examples at each levels of revised Bloom's taxonomy was done by the normal video. Specifically, reflection spot used this particular probing feature, where they were asked to pause and then think about the question. It's not just thinking, they have to write. So if you have followed the video regularly, dedicatedly, then you would have done this exercise. So one more quick question, you can answer it via chat. At what level in revised Bloom's taxonomy is this purpose of application of knowledge, that reflection spot? So the reflection spot, we said that it is prop participants to apply knowledge in revised Bloom's taxonomy. So what level does apply the knowledge come to? Okay, so I'm having, there are some C's and a lot of D's. Oh, there is an A. A, B, C, D. Okay, I think I'll just show you the answer. The answer is only apply. It is not none of the others. Why? Because you have already received the information, and all the underlying levels, the understand and recall levels, are subsumed inside the apply level. And what you are actually doing is, the knowledge that you received about a Bloom's taxonomy level, recall and understand, you are trying to apply it to a new situation, which is your own course and your own topic that I just explained. So whenever you are applying the knowledge that you gained in a new situation, you are only going till apply level. You may think that I am writing my own learning objective, so isn't it a create activity? Just think of this. What is the cognitive process going in your mind? It is not, you are not making something new. You already know some information. All you are doing is, what you are doing is just applying it to a new context. The context is new, but what you are creating is not new. You are already familiar with learning objectives through the examples that were shown in the video. So that is why it is at an apply level. So one more interesting thing, if you note, a normal video which served a recall or understand purposes was elevated to an apply level activity through the activity combination of a video and reflection spot. So a learning three that we want to give you, this is the most important thing, the crux of all the sessions that we are doing. With careful manipulation or activity design, the same technology can be taken to a higher level within the Bloom's taxonomy. So a simple thing as a book or even a video could be elevated to a higher level if we design activities very carefully and use the affordances provided by the technology. So just for people who the normal video plus reflection spot, we are calling it as the learning dialogue, because there is a dialogue that is happening between the instructor and the learner through this reflection spot activity. So one important recommendation that we would be giving you, if you want to increase the effectiveness of the out of class segment of the flipped classroom, or where within blended education, the online aspect of the blended education, if you want to increase, make sure that for the classroom videos, few of them are designed as learning dialogues. So you can give instruction, pause the video at a particular point, think about, post some questions that will engage the learner in the content. So they will be able to apply whatever they learned till that time in a scenario that is completely new to them. So what we are recommending is information acquisition plus application of information by learner to make it more effective. Now, for people who have already done the online quizzes in IIT Bombay X, I'm just showing you a sample online quiz. So what is the learning purpose of an online quiz? You can post your answers through chat. What is the learning purpose of online quizzes or quizzes in general? Remote center coordinators, you can just query the participants right now. So it is not exactly the Bloom's level that we are asking. We are asking the learning purpose. So yes, we are getting some, so it's not the question that we want answer. We want answer to this. What is the learning purpose? So some people are saying to recall and understand, to test and assess, apply and understand, formative knowledge, recall, assessment, assessment effectiveness, apply and understand, to get quick response, check whether learning is happening, or assessment, testing, apply concept in field, effective learning. So yes, most of you have identified it correctly. The learning purpose is actually the to assess or assessment, to assess whether students have acquired the necessary knowledge. Now, if you actually answer the question, you will see a button like this, show answer. What this show answer does is, suppose you have given an answer, it provides an explanation. Explanation as to why an answer is right and why another, what you selected is wrong. So what does this show answer or this explanation achieve in addition to assessment? So the question is, what do the explanation that has been provided along with online quizzes achieve in addition to assessment? Verification and validation, feedback, clear misconception, analyze, understand. So we are not talking about Bloom's taxonomy levels. We'll come to Bloom's taxonomy levels shortly, but we want the learning purpose. Learning purpose is something more than just Bloom's taxonomy levels. So clarification, explanation, self-analysis, enhancing understanding, understanding the concept, proof, understanding ability. So these are some of the answers that you are seeing in the chat right now. Understanding purpose. So let me just state it. So the learning purpose is, along with assessment, you have to give feedback, or it is the feedback to the learner. So what you said, most of you said, it is, have they clarified, it's a clarification, it is a self-analysis. So all these have been provided by this explanation. So this entire activity where you have online quiz along with an explanation, we are calling them as learning by doing activity. And to increase effectiveness for the out of class segment of your flipped classroom or blended learning, we recommend there are assessments present in the out of class or the online segment that provide feedback to the learner. So it's not just the question and multiple options that are important. It is also important to state why an option is right, why are the other options not correct in terms of an MCQ. And if you are putting an open-ended question, you'll have to clearly say what all are the important parameters that needs to be considered in while answering that question. So this is the amount of feedback that has to go along with the assessment strategy. Since you don't, so typically in a traditional classroom, when you post a question, you have the instructor has sufficient time to provide feedback on various answers. In online, you have to make use of the technology to facilitate this feedback process. And most of these technologies that have been used for assessment provide this functionality. So make use of it to increase the effectiveness of the out of class segment or the online aspect of the blended learning. So I'll just recap what we have done. While giving out of class or online content, ensure that there is information acquisition plus application of information by learner, as shown by the LED videos which had the video plus reflection spot. And while giving assessment, ensure that there is assessment plus feedback in terms of explanation. So this is, so if you carefully look at it, we are tying it to the learner. We are not tying it to the instructor. For whom is this online learning important? So the learning is important for the learner, and hence we are focusing on the learner always. So focus the technology purpose to the learner. So I'm going to do another activity. This activity is called team, pair and solo. So most of you would have participated in the discussion forums by now. So there is extensive participation within the IIT Bombay X discussion forums. So what we are looking at is now into the discussion forum feature of IIT Bombay X platform, and we are looking at the purposes, the learning purposes that a discussion forum bring in. So as a team, so you can take the entire RC, consider the entire RC as a team, together discuss and come up with four learning purposes of discussion forums. So why should somebody use a discussion forum in an online or blended learning? What is the learning purpose? So please make sure that it is a learning purpose, not a teaching purpose. What are the learning purposes for which discussion forums can be created or designed? You have around 4 minutes to discuss this among your RC. So you don't have to immediately post the answer. Make sure that as a team, you discuss it within your RC. Discuss and share the answer to it. Give us four learning purposes of discussion forum. You have 4 minutes to do it. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of chat logs, yes, which are valid. So somebody is saying about collaboration, so somebody is common solutions, enhanced learning, peer review, share resources, links, empower students, faculty to express themselves. They are all valid. Clarification, knowledge sharing, participants interaction and resource creation. Very good. This is 1015. Okay, 1063, peer learning to know various aspects of same topic, discuss appropriateness of activity or topic, collaborative learning. Very good. So, yes, most of you are actually doing the right thing. Collaborative resource creation, yes, it's a valid one. To build strong basics, please elaborate it a little more. To gain knowledge, yes. To get a good job. I'm not sure how discussion forums can achieve you good job. Yes, maybe Stack, if you are a good poster in forums like Stack Exchange and other things, you can put it in your CV. I think that is the connection that you can make. Yeah, but it is not. So, please note, discussion forums, primary learning purpose. So, it's not the learning purpose. Getting a job is not a learning purpose. Yes, development of critical thinking and writing skills. Very good. So, somebody for posting in forums, you have to actually think about a lot and then start posting while responding to answers and other things. So, this articulation skill is pretty important in discussion forum. Idea and knowledge sharing, yes. You can stop sending the information via chat. I'm just going to show you some of the these are the four main abstract levels that I've identified. So, one is the information acquisition, where you get information like in the IIT Bombay X or the Moodle forums, you are provided information about dates, announcements, maybe about topics and all those things. Then there is something known as information retrieval. So, I am always talking of discussion forums from the point of view of a learner. As a learner, I get information from this discussion forums about various aspects of the course like dates, announcements. Then there is something known as information retrieval. We can use tags or selected queries to retrieve select discussions of interest. So, you can follow discussions in IIT Bombay X forum and you can actually use following button to see what all topics are you actually looking in the discussion forum. Then there is this idea of concept clarification. So, you have some doubts, you will have get clarification through by posting in discussion forums. And finally, a review or feedback where you post artifacts or opinions and get review or feedback both from instructor and peers. So, discussion forum is a public forum. So, it is not just an interaction between a learner and instructor. It is also a forum for, it's a platform for interaction between learner and the peer or the community. So, these are the four main learning purposes of a discussion forum. Now that you know the four major learning purposes, within your RC, pair up with your neighbor and identify the learning purposes that you have utilized in the IIT Bombay X discussion forums. We have identified four main purposes as a pair. It's not a team activity, it's a pair activity. You and your neighbor discuss with each other how have you used IIT Bombay X discussion forums till now. This is the time that you have to do an activity. You have to pair up within your RC with your neighbor and identify the learning purposes that you have used IIT Bombay X discussion forums for. So, yes, so I am getting some responses from remote centers, acquisition, expressing view, all the four, concept clarification, all four, feedback, information acquisition. If you are limiting yourself to one purpose, it is a wrong practice. All the four are valid purposes of a discussion forum and it is up to you. So, each learner may use a technology differently. So, this is just to show you how various learners use various technologies. So, you provide them a technology, the user may use it in multiple ways. This is just to highlight that particular point. and all the answers are valid. If you are using it for all four, well and good, the effectiveness improves. So the more you use a particular technology, the more learning purposes for which you use a technology, more effective the teaching learning will become. Somebody has noted an effective appreciation, which is a valid learning purpose. So you appreciate somebody else, observe multiple views. So yes, it is also valid. Some people may just go through discussion forums to observe what is happening, what are the different ideas that are being posted. That is also a valid learning purpose. You learn from these observations. So that is the information retrieval that we were talking about. It will come under information retrieval. Get feedback or answer for points raised by us. So yes, so you are a clarification or review or feedback. So I think that will come under feedback, clarification and feedback. Okay, so now we move to the solo activity. So this is an individual activity. You don't need to send this through chat. Individually identify possible ways in which you will be able to further use discussion forum. So you don't need to send it through chat. As a team, you have identified various ways in which discussion forums can be used. As a pair, you identified the specific purposes for which you have used IIT Bombay X discussion forums. Now, as an individual, think of various other learning purposes that you have not explored till now. So some people have explored all four. So think of some additional learning purpose that you can achieve through IIT Bombay X discussion forums. So this is an individual activity. So think of it and implement it. So we want you to go back to discussion forum and use whatever you have identified, make use of it. So this is like a homework task which will go on till the end of this faculty development program. Identify what you have not used the discussion forum for, and then devise a way through which you can use it. Improve the communication. Yes, it's a skill improvement. So it can be used as a skill improvement tool. So people, you don't need to send it the answers through chat, because this is an individual activity. We expect you to identify one area where you can improve, and we hope that during the coming weeks you will be going to using this discussion forum facility to improve upon whatever you are lacking right now. So the IIT Bombay X discussion forum, I'm talking in terms of a designer now, as a technology designer, we have designed it to be structured. So if you actually click the all discussions, you will see this particular window popping up. So all the general discussions will come under the general tab, and specifically the discussions that are relevant to week 2 is coming under this week 2 tab. So you had already seen the first activity where you compare two classrooms, classroom A and classroom B, and then there is a second discussion forum activity where you have to provide a plan for a flipped classroom in your course. So it is, we asked you to post it in the discussion forum. So if you click any of these tabs, you will find discussions relevant to that topic. Another important feature of the discussion forum, it is both guided and it is very focused. So we have designed it to be very focused through focus question for discussion. So for example, this particular question, based on the examples discussed in the video, how will you implement a flipped classroom in your own course? So the LED video had some examples by Professor Sridhar, where he talked of how he used TPS along with in his programming course. Then he used some concept clarification, group problem solving, etc. As part of the flipped classroom strategy, the in-class segment of the flipped classroom strategy. Now, the instruction for discussion was post your idea in the discussion forum below, explaining your domain, course and topic in which you want to do a flipped classroom, your idea for the in-class activity. You are also instructed to comment on the post put up by 2 or 3 peers. So this, these are the instructions for the discussion, whereas there is a very focused question as to what should come in this particular discussion forum, which brings us to the third recommendation. To increase effectiveness of the out of class segment, create structured and guided discussion forums for community to collaborate. So it's not just putting up a discussion forum, that alone will not suffice. You will have to ensure that the discussion forum is structured and the discussions are guided through focus questions. Now for this activity, I am going to explore some features of IIT BX discussion forums. Many of you might be aware by this time, but this is specifically to show you various features that are available in the discussion forum that you can make use in the coming days. So I'm going to share my screen over here. I'm logged into my IIT Bombay X course right now. So this is the discussion forum in IIT Bombay X. So if you happen to see the left hand side, you will see a list, the menu bar. It consists of all discussions. So when I click all discussions, it shows me all those discussions that have happened, that are happening in the discussion forum. So there are lots more below this. So there are one important thing that you would have noticed by this time is the first few weeks are very active. You have lots of posts by participants, either for the various learning purposes that we have posted earlier. So you can specifically see the week 2 discussions by clicking on the week 2 button. So if you see, all these are the week 2 discussions. You can see teacher A and teacher B, flipped classroom activity. Somebody has said about advanced communication skills. So they have put up their flipped classroom idea. The domain, topic, target learners. This person has not yet received a response, but one important thing is he has done his part. Now as a community, you have to assist this person by providing feedback or your feedback or review about this particular flipped classroom, the in-class segment of flipped classroom. You can see some of the posts have got responses. So the numbers show you how many responses they have got, the original post. So this is the kind of response, and response comes at two levels. You can directly add a response or you can respond as a comment. So when somebody posts an answer, if you feel that something else can be added, you can provide your comments on top of it. So this is about the menu bar in discussion forum. So the search feature will provide you with, so let us say somebody wants to, there is this query, so I don't have anybody in my domain, how will I find them? So let's say my topic is about digital electronics. So the moment I type this keyword, digital electronics, I can see a lot of discussions which has this keyword, digital electronics, coming up. So you can actually go and see what each of them have said, and you can actually pair up. So some people, they were saying about arts. So any management teacher in the FDP. So somebody has posted this. So people are responding to it. Management, I'll just check for the keyword management. So there are lot of discussions around the topic management. So you can see, I think financial market, levels of product, all these are clearly management level topics. So when you put up a specific query, you can get all the results in the discussion forum. Now if you want to search for a specific user, so I am just searching for my name over here. This is my username. So you can see all the posts that I have made. The post could be a original post or a response or comment. All these will be coming in over here. And if I click my name, it shows me that I have started 5 discussions and I have commented on 37 of them. Now, I know for sure that there are people who have done more discussion posts and more number of comments, as Professor Fatak pointed out yesterday. There are people who have done more than 100. So, and I think after yesterday's morning, the activity in the discussion forum has increased a lot. So, I will not be surprised if I have been overtaken by a lot of you by this time. Now, the third feature that I am looking at is a very specific aspect about search results. So, there is something called show the results that you want to see within the discussion forum, and specific you can sort it by specific the activity or other aspects. So, we discussed about the basic aspects of the discussion forum. So, if you actually go into the IIT Bombay X discussion forum right now and just click it, the first aspect you can actually, it is the structured aspect of it. There is a search window where you can search for usernames, search for specific topics. If you want to find partners, you can search for posts with specific titles, and for people who want to see the posts, all you have to do is in the search window type the username. Type your username in the search window and then click search, and it will show you something like this. Show posts by specific username. These posts, it can show all the posts, it can show the unread posts, the unanswered or flagged. So you can filter them using these buttons, and you can also filter them based on recent activity, most activity, by most votes. Now, this is one more concept in the discussion. So, if you carefully look at a discussion post, there is something called known as votes on the right hand side of it. So, currently I am just showing you a discussion post which does not have any votes. So, for people, one advice that we would give you for effective use of this discussion forum is, the moment you see some helpful post, we would want you to upvote it. And the reason why I am saying this is because there are many users who are not effectively using the discussion forum across the past 2 weeks. And this specific session is about how to use technology features for specific learning purposes, and using the upvotes and other things will help the learner to filter it based on most votes or most activity and get the post that is more interesting or more relevant for them from the discussion forum. And within the posts, you have multiple edit features, bold italics. You can provide hyperlinks, you can provide quotes, quote blocks can be inserted, images. So, there are a lot of these formatting features that are available in a discussion forum. And why should somebody use it? This is because this is a primary skill that you should have in an online or blended learning, that you should be able to navigate through a discussion forum effectively. You should be able to find relevant posts, you should be able to contribute to the relevant posts, and you should get relevant information from these discussion forums. Discussion forums are one of the vital elements in blended and online education, because the face-to-face interaction is very less, and most of the time the instructor or your peers will get many of the concept clarification, so all the learning purposes satisfied through discussion forums. So, people who have not seen this till now, you can just go to the IIT Bombay X discussion forums and explore all these features. We will be soon posting discussion forum etiquettes, guides to how to post in discussion forum and how to navigate through discussion forum. We initially thought many of you might be knowing it, but it is important that we reiterate it and we post it in the next week's along with the next week's course content. Now, this is a debate activity. So you saw about effective design of discussion forum and use of discussion forum. So essentially the question is, does effective design imply effective views? This is not just limited to discussion forum. You have to think of all the ICT, the technology. So does effective design of a tool or a technology imply its effective views? So you can do this as a debate. So in a debate, you can form two groups. One group can take the role of a technology developer. So consider yourself as a technology developer. And the other group can think of themselves as a technology user. Now, identify all relevant points regarding this question. Is effective design, does effective design imply effective views? Now, as a remote center coordinator, you can convey the various points that emerged in the IIT Bombay X discussion forum question. So there is a very specific question which has been pinned in the discussion forum. So by pinning, what we mean is it has been put on top. So the question is, does effective design of the tool imply its effective use? We request all participants to form two groups and identify various points for this question. The remote center coordinator or the workshop coordinator can then post these points under this discussion forum topic in IIT Bombay X. So once the debate is over, you can move on to tea break, and we will reassemble after tea break at 11:20.